it, which is something that I learned about even before I watched the film. And somehow that made it less intimidating, because it seemed to make it more personal that the first part of it was set in 1920s Italy, and that it was going to end in the present moment. The passions, the incest, the rage, the murder, they're all political, they're connected to issues of authority, but they're also connected to issues of authority in a more abstract sense, in a more abstract sense of the authority that comes with knowing, the authority that comes with pretending not to know. And a lot of the people in Oedipus seem to be doing their best not to know something, while at the same time acting as though they know. So it's almost as the position in which you know something is a way of not knowing something that may be more disturbing. What he seems to be able to do in the film, much ahead of commentators academic or other commentators on Freud, is to take on the strange understanding, the strange and fascinating understanding of time in psychoanalysis, and the way in which it moves, which is almost like the way in which Oedipus, the character, moves sort of without necessarily linear direction, but at the same time towards something that seems like fate. There's one point where Pasolini says that he feels like the relationship to the mother is somehow outside of history, and that the relationship to the father, that's, and the rivalry with the father, that's somehow something that produces history and that produces movement in history. And I read that, and I was really annoyed. And then I thought, that can't be. But also because it can't be, because that's not entirely what happens in
come se fosse stato mio padre. Ora che il suo potere è passato a me, che sono miei i suoi possessi, e sua moglie è mia moglie.
What he says something like he's trying to reproject psychoanalysis onto the myth. So it's almost like a film version of the story of Oedipus read through Freudian psychoanalysis. And that just sounds like a recipe for something that's going to be really boring and insufferable. Except that it isn't. It's terribly moving, it's really frightening. I watched it in the morning and I thought that this was the craziest start to the day that I could have.